Hey, what is going on, guys? In today's video, I will show you how to set up WordPress within Docker. We will talk about Docker configuration for local development, for production, and how to perform full database backup. If you're new here, like and subscribe. And if you like my videos, let me know what you want to see next in the comments. So, let's start from Docker configuration for local development. Create file docker-compose-yaml. There are currently three versions of compose file format. We will use the latest at this moment, which is 3.8. For this setup, we will need WordPress, MySQL, and Nginx Docker images, which are available in Docker Hub. You can find the project source code on GitHub. The link will be in the description. Now we can add service for database. In the environment section, we should define variables for database name, user, password, and password for root. And I will use volume for database files. Also, you can specify paths to accessing database backup, which will be applied after creation of database. It's quite useful to quickly populate local database with test data or when you migrate production project to Docker. Next service will contain the codebase and will be based on FPM Alpine version of the latest WordPress image. This service depends on database service. It means that first database will be launched and only then WordPress. Let's set environment variable for database host. And for this, we should use name of the database service. All other credentials will stay the same. If you have custom code or planning to write it, mount local folder VP content into Docker container. With this action, you will override default WordPress VP content folder with your local one. Also, it will allow you to keep under version control system all changes made in WordPress, such as adding, upgrading or removing plugins, translations, themes, and uploading images. Now let's create a service for Nginx, and I will map container port 80 into host 8080. I have already prepared Nginx configuration for WordPress, which should be mounted into a container. This configuration contains basic root logic and processing PHP files. The important part here is to specify into parameter fuzzyjoypath name of the service where PHP interpreter is located. In our case, it's WordPress. Port 9000 is default port for PHP FPM. Nginx service is created, but it has no files from WordPress, so you will get 404 in case you launch project like this. In order to reuse entire WordPress codebase, create a volume in WordPress service and use it in Nginx. We should also tell Docker that Nginx service will use volume from another service by using volumes from. And Nginx service will also depend on WordPress service. Configuration is ready. To launch our application, we should execute command docker compose app. Open browser and navigate to localhost 8080, and WordPress project will be launched. Everything is done, but with this setup, sending emails will not work. The easiest solution which I have found is to use postfix smtp relay docker image. The link to this image you will find in the description. To configure this service, you should set environment variables with your domain name. Write me in comments how you handle sending emails via Docker. Let's move on to creating Docker configuration for production. Duplicate this configuration file and name docker-compose-prod-yaml. Only a few things should be changed. Rename database, switch database file storage from volume to the host, and WordPress image will be built using our custom image. For this, create file docker file. This image will be based on WordPress image, and we will store entire folder VP content inside the image. We should set proper permissions and set user www.data as owner. Your website should be HTTPS. If it's not, check out my video how to add HTTPS using free tool Let's Encrypt. So, add one more environment variable to force SSL login. Now we can run Docker Compose with newly created config to launch project with production configuration. I don't like phpMyAdmin, so instead I will show you how to connect to the database from PHP Storm. First, we should expose MySQL port to the host machine, because by default port is not reachable outside Docker network. Open database window, click plus, and select data source. Pick MySQL from the list. Keep host and port as they are. Set user, password, and database name same as they are set in Docker compose file. Click OK. If you did everything correctly, you will see list of all tables in the database window. By double clicking, you can open table and perform search or change its entries. Okay, last step, make database backup. And for this, execute this command. So, here we execute MySQL dump command inside db docker container, using environment variables which were defined in docker compose file. Now you can add this command into cron or execute manually. That's it. Thanks for watching.